Welcome to Care Coordination and Interoperable Health IT Systems, Implementing Health Interoperability, Lecture A. This unit will cover the following learning objectives. Number 1. Identify major tasks required to implement interoperability. Number 2. Explain why interoperability implementation projects are needed. Number 3. Define and discuss each phase of the interoperability implementation lifecycle. Number 4. Describe how to apply each phase of the interoperability implementation lifecycle to simple interoperability implementation problems. And number 5. List types of production issues with interoperability and identify and describe support strategies. This lecture introduces the healthcare interoperability implementation lifecycle and why interoperability implementation projects are needed. It also discusses the first step in any healthcare interoperability implementation, which is the organize phase. Vendors provide interoperability capabilities. Interoperability implementation projects are needed to utilize those capabilities to achieve interoperability between systems. Most health IT systems provide specific interoperability capabilities. These are usually referred to as their interfaces. These interfaces allow them to send and receive information with other systems. For example, a laboratory information systems vendor provides an interface to accept orders and another interface to send results. An EHR might provide an application programming interface, or API, allowing other systems to query for patient medication lists. A health information exchange, or HIE, might provide the ability to generate and send a care summary that contains a patient's encounter information from multiple provider organizations. Implementing interoperability is the work required to integrate the interoperability capabilities together of two or more systems to solve a specific problem for a particular site or implementation. An example is the implementation of laboratory orders and results interoperability between a physician practice and a laboratory it commonly uses. The practice's EHR might have a standard interface capability to send orders and to receive results. The laboratory might have a standard interface capability to send specific laboratory results between a doctor's office and a commercial lab, so that the doctor's office receives regular updates on lab results for their patients. Another example is implementing an immunization reporting interface between a hospital and the local public health authority so that the public health authority is notified whenever the hospital immunizes a patient. A healthcare interoperability implementation project is one in which you need to connect one or more interface capabilities of two or more systems to solve an interoperability problem. There is a life cycle for the implementation of healthcare interoperability. On this slide is a table of steps adapted from Winston Royce. There are 6 steps. Number 1, organize. Number 2, analyze. Number 3, design. Number 4, build. Number 5, test. And number 6, go live. In the life cycle, you begin with project planning. And then you explore the problem and discover its detailed requirements. Then you determine the best way to solve it. You build the solution. You test the solution. And you carefully and methodically put your solution into production. These steps should be included in a project plan when implementing interoperability, because skipping steps can lead to problems in production that could create financial costs and compromise patient care. You should expect to have to go back a step or to repeat steps. Although vendors provide capabilities to connect their systems to other systems, the connection is often not seamless and may require special configuration or customization to make it work for a specific site. Testing to confirm that it works for a specific site, site-specific workflow changes and training to support the interoperability functionality, and/or local policies and sharing agreements. Implementation work can sometimes be significant, and special translations on middleware may be required to achieve interoperability. Work will be minimized if vendors have implemented robust standards and implementation guides and have already tested with many other vendors and if the implementation site is comfortable with their vendor's standard offerings. However, all interoperability implementation at least requires testing, workflow changes, and training. However, there are ways to reduce the size and complexity of implementation projects. First of all, vendors should follow the standards. They should prove their compliance by certification, such as the ONC Certification of Interoperability features in the ONC 2015 certification. Vendors should also prove they are interoperable with other vendors by participating in events where they can test with other vendors. Providers should be careful not to over-exercise the customization features their vendors provide to allow non-standard solutions. When a provider wants to replace the system, they will have a hard time replicating non-standard features. Finally, interoperability standards and implementation guides need to be continually improved based on feedback from implementation experience. Standards development efforts at the national and international level should continue to work on improving the robustness of standards. The first step or phase in the life cycle is organize. It is key to follow project management principles and include in a project plan the project charter and other important documentation. Examples of planning documentation are budget, schedule, risk plan, communication plan, and control plan. For more information on project management, refer to Component 19. Interoperability projects have special considerations. They often have hidden complexity, so be prepared to manage a growing scope. Complexities often include variance in vendor capabilities, workflow challenges, training needs, and policy issues, such as regulations affecting data sharing. Secondly, such projects involve numerous and diverse stakeholders. Stakeholders can include multiple departments, users, teams, vendors, and organizations. The team working on interoperability projects often does not follow typical departmental boundaries. For lab orders and results interoperability implementation, it might include clinician representation, EHR IT representation for the physician practice, EHR vendor representation, laboratory clinical staff, laboratory IT representation, laboratory information system vendor representation, and interface engine representation. It is very important to identify all the players and their roles, especially project management and leadership. Because there could be many stakeholders, leadership must be clear. A tip for planning an implementation project is to create and adhere to a unifying project charter. Since the project spans departments and organizations, it is especially important to have a shared vision. Consider the Agile method for implementation, which allows you to quickly prototype solutions. End users benefit from prototyping so that they see how interoperability will work. Also, since the project has hidden complexities, breaking it into smaller, prioritized projects makes sense. The lifecycle steps should be included as tasks in the project plan because each one is important. By carefully following these steps, you can identify issues before the project is too far along. The less you have actually implemented, the cheaper it is to resolve or cancel. Due to the diversity of stakeholders, a consistent and comprehensive communication plan is critical. Smaller projects will not need as much formal management. So adjust the amount of formal management accordingly, because the amount depends on the size and complexity of the project. These tips will help with any kind of project, but especially one for implementation of health interoperability. This concludes Lecture A of Implementing Health Interoperability. This lecture explained how healthcare interoperability implementation projects are needed to achieve interoperability between systems. It defined the six steps to the healthcare interoperability implementation lifecycle as organize, analyze, design, build, test, and go live. It then discussed the first step, organize. Getting organized is crucial for an interoperability implementation project. It is when the project is planned.